from ALA 2014 in Las Vegas, and we had an absolute blast.
It was amazing.
We're kind of still trying to recuperate from the crazy heat, but overall we had an amazing time. We met tons of awesome people and saw a lot of great sessions, which we will start to cover now.
Yeah, but before we start with those sessions, I need to share something spectacular.
It's kind of a big deal.
It is. At JFK Airport in New York City, I'm eating my Egg McMuffin. I looked up, what do I see? Judy Blume.
The Judy Blume.
I know we are ready for the best trip of our lives.
Yes. So what better way to start the conference?
Yep.
That was amazing.
Amazing. Let's start off with those sessions. What we're going to do is we're going to highlight a few sessions that we thought were awesome and that you should know about.
So one of the first sessions that we went to was the AASL Best Apps for Teaching and Learning, which EasyBib was honored to receive last year. So we really wanted to check out and see which new apps were being honored this year. It included tons and tons of great apps, including ones like Duolingo, which I'm already using myself. So it's great for grown-ups and also kids. And also a really great website called Instagrop, which EasyBib actually has integration with as well.
That's awesome.
So make sure to check out the link in the blog just to see all of the apps that were available and made the cut for this year's list.
Another session that we want to share with you is AASL's Best Websites for Teaching and Learning. Their chair is Heather Moorfield Lang, and with the committee, she shared 25 awesome websites. Included were ThingLink, Haiku, PearlTrees, and Storify.
So what if I want to, you know, nominate an app or website for next year? How do I go about doing that?
If you have a favorite app or website that you like to use in your classroom or library, you can nominate it by going to the links found in the blog. You have up until March 1st, 2015, so you have some time to get those nominations in.
Yay! Another awesome session that went on during ALA was done by Joyce Valenza, and it focused around how students can stay connected around the world.
Yeah, by using Skype or Google Hangouts or Flipgrid, students can learn and connect with others across the world. She showcased some amazing projects, some done by Shannon Miller and others across the United States. One of my favorite parts of her presentation was Joyce sharing her personal project to connect others across the world. She's using Flipgrid, and every so often she asks a question. And teachers and educators and librarians can share their answers and learn from each other across the world. If you would like to learn more, check out the hashtag GlobalTL.
There were awesome sessions going all throughout the conference, even up until Monday afternoon. Our friend Chris Harris had this great session that was packed with people called Play, Play, Learn, Games in the Common Core.
Yeah, what he did was he introduced participants to game theory and taught them how to identify successful game elements that went along with Common Core standards.
Chris took exact, specific Common Core state standards and then aligned them with games that he's actually been using across his school district in New York. He's actually developed this board game library, and he set up this new website, playplaylearn.com, where you can learn all about it, and you guys should definitely check it out. He is super knowledgeable on board game theory and applying it to learning.
In fact, you should check out Chris Harris's webinar that he did with EasyBib earlier this year, all about board games and how to include them in your library and classrooms. You should definitely check it out.
There were also tons of great booths in the exhibit hall. It was our first time going to a national conference, and it was just completely overwhelming.
You know what? I'm still bummed because I definitely didn't get a chance to walk around and see every single booth in that exhibit hall.
It was really hard to take it all in.
Personal favorite, Mango Languages. Not only do they have an awesome product, but if you stop by their booth, you got a free mango slushie.
And it was so good. Michelle brought one back for me, and it was just like the most refreshing, delicious beverage.
Thank you, Mango Languages.
We also wanted to highlight Overdrive Libraries. They've had tons of new features that have come out in recent months. One personal highlight for both of us was that we were able to meet one of our Twitter friends in real life. If you guys are on Twitter, definitely follow Overdrive Libs. They are posting tons of great and useful resources, and for a long time we never knew who was behind it, and then it turns out it's our friend Andrew.
Hi Andrew.
Hi Andrew.
And that's a cool thing about these national conferences, is that you get to meet people that you're friends with on Twitter or Tumblr, and it's great to finally put a face to a name.
We have one last takeaway that we want to share with you guys. You know, working in the library field, and especially after going to ALA, we're hearing a lot about libraries that have a lack of funding or are just in really dire straits and need a little bit of help, but they don't know where to go.
Yeah, we're reading about this way too often. Well, Every Library is a nonprofit organization that helps train, coach, and consult libraries across the United States to get voter and community support. We met them at ALA, the whole crew, and they're doing an awesome job and getting a lot of support to help libraries. So if you get a chance, head to their website, everylibrary.org.
While we had an awesome time in Vegas, it is nice to be back in New York.
Yeah, back in the city, and we're already looking forward to next year in San Francisco. That's it for today.
Guys, let us know what you thought about ALA or ISTE. We didn't get to go, but we heard great things, so let us know what were your favorite parts of the conference, whether it was presentations or booths. We'd love to hear what you have to say.
Yeah, please leave some comments below. We'll see you next time for the
Lively Librarians. Bye, guys.
That doesn't make any sense.
So while Vegas was super fun, it was also stupid hot.
Yeah, we're definitely glad. But hey, what can you do? Hey, what can you do, everyone? Well, thanks.
We're so bad at improvising. Okay.
Isn't it unfortunate? I said to say that.
You were just really excited when you were saying, okay.